Oh crap, what's going on there? Hang on. Something glitched up. Okay, that's better. Okay, so let's get started on Mabinogi stuff. So first things first, let's start a pet expedition, because I'll have to do that for my second coffee coin quest. And they take a minimum of 36 minutes to finish. Oh, looks like I don't have any 36 minute missions today. It looks like they're all over an hour. So the shortest mission we can do is an hour and 12 minutes. I guess that's still fine. Alright, let's pick our pets. So this can get us Homestead Seed. We want that. That'd be a good bonus reward. So we need a dog pet, a terrestrial pet, a small pet, large pet, medium pet, and two creatures. Okay, 93% chance of getting the bonus reward. So let's send those guys on an expedition. And they'll be done in an hour and 12 minutes, or 72 minutes. And then we'll exit. And then let's do the first coffee coin mission, which is do one of your daily shadow missions. So what kind of shadow missions do we have today? So we have Fulmer Attack and Tara and defeat the Shadow Commander or whatever in Tailton. Okay, let's go Tailton. See what the missions over there are. And your VIP mission will actually count as one of your daily shadow missions for the coffee coin quest if you have VIP. Beat the Shadow Wizard, okay. And Offering. Let's just defeat the Shadow Wizard, I guess. Why not? We'll do it on hard mode. And let's go ahead and use our Shuriken for that. At least the gold drops will be good on hard mode. And then pull out this stall bag. Okay, here's the first orb. We'll find as many of them as we can. Oh, my shuriken's out of durability. Oops. Let's go ahead and equip our backup shuriken, which is the memoir one. Okay, another orb is over here. Let's use some Dance to Death. They sure do spawn a lot of these things. Yeah, there should be another orb somewhere over here. Here it is, the screen one. Let's get this one next. Dance to Death, and let's go 5. Because then we can use Encore and do it again.
Thank you.
Okay, where to next? Let's see what else we can find. Let's see. There's another orb. There has to be one here somewhere. Wait, is this where we came in? Yeah, it is. Over here. Here's one. Dance to death. Encore, then dance to death again. Wow, someone's just achieved their 20th Grandmaster talent. Wow. That is awesome. I think there are only like about 20 talents in the game, aren't there? So I think that's like all of them. That's impressive though. Because to get 20 different talents to the master rank and then to do the grandmaster missions for all of them. Like, that's a very impressive accomplishment. Not to mention that the certificates to actually pass once you have all 10 seals cost 1 million gold each. So, I mean, that's around 20 million gold in total. Well, hang on, how many talents are there? So there's One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Sixteen, 17, 18, 19, 20. Yeah, so there are 20 talents. Wow. Okay, there's an orb right up here. Let's go ahead and hit that one. How many more barriers are left? There should only be like one or two more orbs. There should only be like one more. Here's one. This might be the last one. Okay, are there any more barriers on that thing left? Let's see if we can go inside. Still up, huh? That's weird. That means we're missing at least one more orb. So where is it? Oh, that might be it. Okay, there we go. Now we can go fight the boss. Okay, there we go. Okay, so next let's go to Rathroliel Castle. And that's on page 5, gate 2, no gate 3. And we'll talk to Lazaro and start working on Grandmaster missions. So we are currently working on getting our Grandmaster Bard, and we have half the seals we need. So you need 10 seals, and we have 5 of them. How much gold do I have? Okay. So, Grandmaster, third mission for Bard. Grandmaster, second mission for Bard. And Grandmaster, first mission for Bard. So what are the quests? Clear Pika Abyss. Well, we're clearly not going to do that. Use the Discord skill 100 times. And clear Guardian of Avon on hard. Okay, so... the Guardian of Avon 1 is easily doable. Let's go ahead and switch to my Knuckles, which have plenty of durability. And we need a swing by Dumbarton, so... go there. Oh, Himiko Mio, thanks for the raid. Okay, so I can use Adventure Seals to buy the Guardian of Avon Pass, so it costs 7 Adventure Seals. And we're off to Avon. And next part of the stage. Okay, this is the one with the snow trolls. Okay, now for the boss. Meteor should do it in one shot. And then let's use the event feather and go to the Tara Gallery. I can't even see the NPC. Oh wait, there he is. Okay, so let's talk to him. Then we get a free prize box and a coffee. Oh, and this one gives you 700% EXP. And it says it's not tradable, but you can actually put it in your bank and withdraw it with any other character on your account. So you can move it to another character if you want to, doing it that way. Well, let's see what the prize box has. Where'd that thing go? There it is. And the pet age potion. So let's go back to Lazaro and turn in our quest. Alright, and that's our 6th Great Bard Seal. And now let's work on some more Gen 20. So, where are we at with Gen 20? So we're on the quest, The Long Night's Beginning. How far along is that in the story? Okay, well, if we're on this one, then we're pretty close to the end of Gen 20. So where's the location for that? Oh, okay, so in Dumbarton. So maybe we're looking for this thing right here. I think this might be part of something else. Yeah, I think this is one of the future generations. A little bit of lag today. Okay, so that was for one of the future generation things. We need to focus on the, in fact, I'm in the wrong skill tab completely. We want the Divine Knights. Okay, so wrong generation there. So use the necklace in your inventory. Okay, complete that quest. Eternal Memories, so talk to Avalyn at the Scathage Beach Hot Springs. Let's see, where are those at? Okay, so just right in front of the entrance to Avalon Gate. Okay, so talk to Castamian. So where is he at? Okay, right over there. Yeah, well, I'm talking to him and nothing's really happening. Like, we only have two dialogue options and neither one of them are working. He says maybe Altam might know something, so am I supposed to go to him next? Let's find out what's going on here. Okay, here we are. So, Eternal Memories. So, talk to him. If you do not have the option about the training grounds, go back to and talk to Altam. Okay. So that's who I need to find next. Thank you. Yeah, we asked them about the Alban Knights training grounds, so maybe we actually need to go check them out in Dumbarton. So this is the Alban Knights training ground. Alright, let's go back to the, Springs Moongate. I'll try talking to Caspian again. Okay, now we have the option, so about the training grounds. Okay, use Peen's gem located in your inventory. Try going here. Oh, so these are like her memories. Thank you. Okay, so where are we going next? Right here. Hints of death is a good way to deal with these guys. Okay, so where's the next place? Not there. What about this one? Maybe I need to talk to her again. Okay, what am I looking for in this memory? Let's search around a little bit. Oh, here we go. Alright, where'd she go off to? There you are. And now we can complete this quest, and we get the Divine Link practice skill. And another thing to keep in mind is that once we learn Divine Link, we won't have the, where is it? Be somewhere around here. Maybe it's in hidden. Yeah, so right now we have the memorial link, and that's something that you get from doing the memoir quest line. This is just supposed to be a filler skill until you get through Gen 20. So once we complete this quest and learn the divine link, the memorial link skill should vanish. Yep, a memorial link is no longer there because now we have the new one. So now we have the quest, The Return. So how far along are we in Gen 20? Okay, we're on The Return here. And then there are two quests here, so there are like three more quests to do before we're done. We'll probably finish Gen 20 today then. Okay, so now we need to find Avalyn. Oh, is she over here? Yeah. So right across the bridge. Then we're off to Lune Valley. one's right over here. It's a short distance away from the mana tunnel. Okay, so just survive until the time limit's up. Not really gonna be a problem. And we can just use hide. Okay, so survive another minute out here. Okay, survive 2 minutes. It's actually pretty easy if you're an elf with the hide skill. That time he got me. It's still pretty easy to outrun them. Twenty more seconds. After we're finished with Gen 20, we'll probably train up Divine Link a little bit. Oh, so are we actually supposed to take these guys down? There's no time limit now. Instead. Let's charge up to full. Guess there's not enough time to charge it to full. That's all of them. And talk to Talvish after that mission's over. And that quest is done. Forward progress. So, talk to Altam east of the Scathich Springs. Okay, and they're all over here? Okay, then talk to Evelyn. Oh, those are some tall zombies.
Thank you.
So what's the goal here? Defeat all the enemies? Okay, so just defeat them until they stop spawning. This is one of those cases where final hit would actually be really useful. But there are a lot of other advantages in the story to being an elf. Let's get a little bit more MP. There we go, that'll do it for a bit. There we go. Don't need that. Maybe I need to target the wizard. Thank you. Okay, so let's figure out what's going on with this boss. Talk to Talvish, defeat the reanimated corpses. Oh, okay, survive until all the knights are knocked out. That's the goal here. Okay, so now do we actually do damage to them or not? Yeah, now I can actually hurt him. Oh, there's one more left. Okay. All right, and after that mission, talk to Talvish. Okay, and now we have the quest Gate of Sanctuary. So, talk to Talvish. And then talk to Altam. Okay, and then talk to Altam near the gate. And once we complete this quest, we'll get Divine Link rank F. So we'll start training it after that. Mine does not appear. Oh, here we go. And that's it for Gen 20. Okay, so now we have the Guardian of the Gate title and the one who is Avalon's companion and the Gen 20 achievement. So, Crusader skills. Now we can train Divine Link. Let's go ahead and get out of this area. Oops. And I'm going to go to Chernanog and train Divine Link. So to train Divine Link, you do need to have a pet summoned. Mm-hmm. Oh wow, it can be upgraded already. Take that up to rank E. And we get 1 MP, 1 stamina, and 1 dexterity. And 1 MP, 1 stamina, and 1 will. I guess since I'm killing these zombies, they might drop some good gold. So we'll summon that really quick. Oh, ancient zombie. So rank C, 1 MP, 1 stamina, 1 intelligence. Rank B, 1 MP, 1 stamina, 1 strength. And now we need to recast the link. Okay, rank A, 1 MP, 1 stamina, 1 will. And let's use some Dance of Death to speed this up. Thank you. And then dance to death again. And don't let your pet get too far away from you when you're using Divine Link. Because if your pet gets too far away from you, then it'll cancel it. Okay, so rank 9, 1 MP, 1 stamina, 1 dexterity. I wonder how much gold I could sell that helmet for. And rank 8. 1 MP, 1 stamina, 2 strength. Thank you. Rank 7, 1 MP, 1 stamina, 1 dexterity. Okay, rank 6. 1 MP, 1 stamina, 1 intelligence. Now it's getting pretty grindy to train this skill, so it would take a while to get to rank 1. So we'll go ahead and work on something else for a little bit. I think we'll do a little bounty hunting. Let's cancel that doll bag summon. And let's go to Dumbarton. And before I do bounty hunting, I need to make a few repairs too. Is my shuriken's out of durability? And is that the only thing that's super low on durability, or? Well, I should still get repaired. And how much can I sell that helmet for that zombie dropped? $14,800 gold. I can't even use it anyway, it's for humans and giants. Okay, so let's start pursuing Herbert. See if we can have any luck finding him or not. We'll check the Dumbarton area first. See if there's any sign of him. It doesn't look like there are any bandits in the Dumbarton area. Let's check out Dugald Isle. See if there's any bandits down there. Still no signs of any bandits. Maybe we'll try checking out the Garrick area just outside of Bangor. So, let's see. Let's go to the Bangor Moongate. Still nothing. Guess Bryce is out here. That's about it. Alright, well, we'll check out the Senmag next, and if no bandits appear there, then we're just going to give up and do commerce instead. Because Herbert is being tricky to find right now, so just have to try again another day if he doesn't want to show up. Yeah, it doesn't look like we're gonna find Herbert today. So we'll go ahead and stop the pursuit here. And then we'll go ahead and do some commerce. And before we do that, let's go to the homestead. And complete this for the second coffee coin. I should collect some homestead stone while I'm here too. Harvest all this. Then we can plant these ones that we got for completing the pet expedition. And do I have any other homestead seeds? Or is that it? Yeah, I think that's it. Let's go E-Main to do commerce. If we took this overseas, we could get a lot of ducats for it. Yeah, let's grab all that. Okay, here's what we'll do. We'll take this through Bangor and we'll go to Port Sion. And if there's a massive waiting time for the ships, then we'll just go back to Bangor and sell it there. And if there's not a very long waiting time for the ships, then we'll just go to we'll go to Philia or Vales. But Philia would be better. Actually, if I don't want to worry about bandits at all, we're gonna have to use this item eventually. This will prevent all bandit encounters for like the next hour. Okay, and now we're gonna go to Port Sion. And we'll see how long we have before the ships leave. Let's hope we don't have to wait too long. If not, we'll just sell things at Bangor, it's not a big deal. Okay, so it'd be better to sell these in Philia. So let's check out that ship first. It's gonna be 2.5 minutes, that's not worth waiting for. Let's go see how the other one's doing. Yeah, unfortunately, we'd be waiting around for a long time, so let's just go back to Bangor and sell this stuff. Okay, then where should we take this stuff? I would go for a lot in Tara. Tara's kind of a long ways away, though. Let's take it to Cobb for now. And maybe we'll consider taking it to Belvas. How much is it going for in Belvas? 158. Okay, yeah, we'll go to Cobb, and then we'll see what the ship times are for going to Belvest, Anquilla, and we'll consider taking it overseas. Okay, let's check the ship going to Quilla first. The ship is leaving in about 2 minutes. Yeah, alright, we'll go ahead and take this to Quilla, that's fine. And we are now departing for Port Quilla. So it'll take us about 4 minutes to get there. Uh-oh. What's going on here? I actually had this problem with the Belvast ship once a long time ago. Like, I don't know how long ago, about maybe even 1 or 2 months ago. And I fixed it by just repairing the game through, like, Steam, verifying the files and all that crap. So I probably just need to do that again. All right, and we are now at Port Quilla. So I should be able to fix that weird boat glitch just by verifying the integrity of the files through Steam. That should be pretty easy to fix. Okay, let's go here, and let's use one of those letters of guarantee too. All right, and that's a good stopping point for today. We finished Gen 20, and we did our event stuff and made a little bit more progress on Grandmaster Bard. So I will be streaming Mabinogi again on Wednesday.